Assalamu alaikum, dear students. In biology, you will learn about homeostasis and its importance. Homeostasis keeps the internal fluctuation or changes within a narrow range with the help of various systems which are called control systems, as compared to the wider external environment, because fluctuations occur in external environment. Homeostasis is the central requirement in the maintenance of an organism. What are susceptible components? The components which can be affected by fluctuations, changes in external environment are called as susceptible components. For example, water, solute or salts, and temperature. Types of control systems. In order to maintain homeostasis, there are two main control systems. Number one is living control system, and number two is physical control system. Now, what are the components of living control system? There are three components or parts: receptor or sensor. It detects changes from a set point, and then it sends signals to the control center, second component, to take action. For example, photoreceptors. Photo means light, that is those receptors which receive light. And chemoreceptors, which detect chemicals. Second component is control center. Its function is to issue orders to the effectors. Its examples are brain and spinal cord, that is they send signals. Third component is effector. Their function is to show response according to the stimulus or change as ordered by the control center. Its examples are muscles and glands. Glands, you know, produce different kind of secretions, and muscles show response by contraction and relaxation. Now we will discuss components of physical control system. Generally, if an organism wants to maintain temperature within a room, so here room will be physical system. It has also three components. First one is receptor or sensor. It detects temperature change from a set point, and then it sends signals to the second component, control center, to take some action. For example, thermometer. Second component is also control center. It issues orders to the effectors according to the stimulus or change received from the receptors. Its example is switch. And third component is effectors. It shows response according to the stimulus as ordered by the control center. For example, heating or cooling units, and they work according to temperature changes.